Hello, 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 hey, hoi, hey, nice to see you, hoi.
Hello people, welcome back to Souls That Struggle. Thank you to everyone that showed support by either liking, hitting the bell, subscribing, in whatever way, whether you message me. Thanks for your support, and it's good to know that it's helping a lot of people, and a lot of people are speaking out a lot more. That's what we intended to do, and that's what we intend to do. Continually keep positive, people. Refuse to quit. Keep going, man. Stick in there. Times will get hard, but if you stick in there, the rewards are great. People, there's a story I would like to share with you. Interesting one. People, I want to share with you a time when I was having anxiety attacks probably 2-3 times a day, and I decided to go to the doctor. And the doctor, he didn't really ask how I felt or anything. He wasn't really bothered about it. All he was interested in was chucking different tablets and just seeing that, just shutting me down really, so I could just sort of turn robotic in the world and just get on with it. Just get on the mill and just carry on just going through life. So yeah, I ended up on some, I don't know, antidepressant. I think it was called paroxetine, if I remember. And to be honest, I remember when I used to take these things and I was like happy pills, you know, you used to just feel it go through your body and it used to relax you, and just, it was nice to just feel relaxed instead of feeling sort of thing. So you started to depend on these things. It got to the day where you'd think 3 or 4 months in and a few days without the tablet, and your body would sort of remind you, and you'd have like a little shake through your body. Well, I did. I had like a little shake that would sort of send shivers through my body, and I sort of knew then, you know what? And that was the point that got scary, really, because I knew that my body was depending on this shit, and I couldn't get away from it. I was locked in. I was on another chain. This was all just for me, sort of pouring my heart out to the doctor and just saying, is there any way you can help me? Whatever it is, you know. And the doctor's idea was, yeah, of course I can help me. I can give you these happy pills, and these are the way forward. Little did he know, in the small print, these are just another thing to get hooked on. And to be honest, it's easy just to take the tablet and make things better. I've done it and I've been there. After 3 months, I started weaning myself, and I take like a tablet every 3 days. And then gradually I got off these things. Thank the Lord, you know what I mean? I eventually got off these, and to be honest, I think it's been about 6 years since I took an antidepressant, but family-wise and friends-wise, I know thousands of people I'm relying on these tablets every single day. And don't get me wrong, there's no right or wrong thing. But to be honest, I mean, it's up to you. I mean, if you don't take this tablet and you need it to actually function and thingy, then it's got to a point where, listen, you need to take the tablet, or obviously there's no way out sort of thing. But I just think it's bad, really, how doctors can sort of have us in and not sort of take time out to just sort of ask how we're feeling, try other sort of avenues where we can go down before they just throw these fucking tablets and think, you know what, zombie, get over there. You don't need to have an opinion. Just sit in the background and watch it all go on sort of thing. You might think I'm crazy, but that's what I think. I looked into it, and the paroxetine, I think they come in 15 milligram, 30 milligram and 45 milligram. Well, the doctor put me straight on 45 milligram. Is that normal? Like, I thought we had to sort of be edged onto these things, you know. Start with a 15 or something like that. I just thought, I don't know, that seems a bit more the right way. Smaller the dose and then sort of work your way up if you need them in the end. Don't just bang people on 45 milligram. What are you trying to do? You know what I mean? Life's bad enough. But yeah, man, like these times when I was stuck in them fingers, I can smile now about it, you know, but today I'd like to share with you a few bad experiences that I had with anxiety, and a couple of bad places that it took me to, and how I coped or sort of not coped sort of thing, and just how I was with it and how I dealt with my anxiety sort of thing. But yeah, we'll get involved, comment, like, subscribe, hit the bell, get behind us, sort of get involved, people. I know it's hard out there. There's thousands who are struggling.
I've got a question I'd like to ask, if you don't mind.
No problem. Carry on. Fire away.
Could you talk about a specific point in your life when anxiety was difficult to deal with?
Yeah, of course. I mean, there's been a few times, like, more than a few, where I've struggled with anxiety, but to be honest, when I was footballing, I ain't gonna lie, but when I was ready to go out, all I ever felt was butterflies and excitement, so I can't sort of put my anxiety there because I was just buzzing, there was no anxiety, it was all excitement, so in the footballing days, but it got to a point where I'd go home and I never wanted to leave my room, like, sort of thing, and I sort of shut off from the world and I'd create problems in my head and I'd imagine these problems happening to me. And then my anxiety had come because I'd be thinking about this problem happening to me. So I'm just sitting in my room and I've created all this problem from nothing. You know, so this ain't even happened yet. But I'm struggling with it. You know, I'm thinking I've made up a story and I'm struggling. None of this true. None of this is true, sort of thing. So yeah, there was hundreds of times where I'd sit in my room and sort of create things for my anxiety to go off.
Yeah, because it's sort of easier just to shut yourself away from the world, really.
Yeah, it was just the easiest way. I'd have to answer anyone, I'd have to speak to anybody. I can't say I was happy that way, because I was sad and lost, but at the time I just felt sort of as safe as I can and protected alone.
I see.
I struggle to trust humans at times, you know what I mean? There's a lot of bad acts going on out there. Yeah. And every time the more and more that our brain is exposed to, it just makes you doubt the human, you know. Yep. The animals are shining through in their true colours. Look at animals, you know. You know, like, the way animals treat each other, we should learn from animals. But listen, does that not sound crazy? Humans should learn from animals.
Yeah, it does sound crazy, but when you think about it, animals can look after themselves, they can fend for themselves, they don't need supermarkets, they don't need money, you know, they can build their own homes, for example.
I agree, you know, we can't paint every human with the same brush. There's some golden people out there who are shining through, you know, and I admire them. But what I'm saying is there's also some horrible c***, you know what I mean? And
well, back to the anxiety, have you ever felt like pauses and skips and thuds in your heartbeat and like a fast heart rate? I have that issue myself.
Yeah, there's a few times, like, it wasn't much speeding with me. I mean, I've had the speeding heart, but at times it felt like my heart would sort of miss a beat and I was like, you know what I mean? It was like a shock feeling. I was thinking, if that misses another beat, yeah, I'm in trouble, sort of thing. Do you know what I mean? Like, so I was thinking about, you know, I tell people, phone the ambulance, do this and that. Like, they was looking at me crazy, but inside, I was just crying, you know what I mean? I was thinking, my heart's missing a beat, sort of thing, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I've had that experience many times. I mean, I had it today even. For anyone listening, they're called ectopic heartbeats and they're completely harmless.
Heptopic heartbeats? Ectopic.
Hectopic. Hec-E-C. Ectopic
heartbeats.
Yep, and they're completely harmless. They won't hurt you.
See, even the word don't even sound f***ing nice, do you know what I mean? No. Ectopic. It sounds like something's coming for you, yeah, and it's taking you somewhere. Listen, mate, no, I don't like that shit, man.
It's an awful experience, but if you're not used to it.
Yeah, of course, we can laugh. I mean, I have my days now, like, but nothing was half as bad as them attacks and that we used to have, and that you used to worry yourself that much. You used to think, this is it, man. There's plenty of times when I've said, this is it.
I'm interested to know about how you got off the medications and what sort of withdrawal side effects did you have from coming off antidepressants, if you know what I mean.
Okay, listen. So what I did is, yeah, I was struggling because my mind kept convincing me, you am stuck, you am f***ed, sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
You need this tablet every single day.
Yeah.
So I would have little... It's like I would argue with my head thinking, listen, I hate the game, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I would just think, I'm going to fight back. And I constantly had this sort of war going on in my head. And actually, I was mad at the doctor. So I remember phoning the doctor, and to be honest, I was angry at him. When I'm angry, to be honest, I need leaving alone for a bit so I can just go away. I can just think about it. I'll come back, I can reassess it. And then bang, I can tell you when I'm calm what I really think.
Yeah.
But at the time, I'll just say anything. I'll spew all these words. I don't mean them, but
that's,
you know,
exactly
what? I'm angry,
yeah.
And I can't get my point across. So you know what I'm going to do, yeah? I'm going to throw all these words at you. And because I'm angry, I'm going to try and take you with me.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? It was a nasty way to be. but I was that person sort of thing, do you know what I mean? So I used to phone the doctor, and I phoned the doctor twice, and I was thinking, who's this doctor think he is, you know what I mean? He's got me hooked on these tablets, and he thinks I'm just going to hide away in the corner and be quiet. So I phoned him up a few times, and I spoke to him, and I just said I tried to explain it's never f***ing right and that, but listen, I ain't going to change all this shit, you know what I mean? People are laughing. I've had my little say, and that's that. And I thought, I need to get off these, you know, that's the only thing. So what I started to do is I started 45 milligram tablet, so I'd half the tablet, so it was 22.5 milligram, yeah?
Yeah.
So every day I'd take half a tablet, so I was on 22.5 milligram a day. That was okay, so after a week, I'd miss a day, and then I'd take half a tablet. And it got to a point after 3 or 4 weeks where I was taking a tablet every 3 or 4 days. So the most tablets I was taking a week was 2 tablets.
So you tapered yourself off them?
So I tapered myself off them. Yeah. I'd get these little shakes and anxiety things go through my body, letting me know that I hadn't had my tablet. But I would wait for them to come on, and then bang, I would have my antidepressant.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, nice. But I would wait till the end and go till the end until I couldn't go no more. I think I hadn't had a tablet for about... I think I was taking like one a week then. That's what it had come to. And then it was one every... No, it wasn't even one every 2 weeks. It was one every week. And then after that, after about 2 weeks of one a week, I never took one. I got off them, you know, with God's help. That's all I'm saying. Because at the time, I thought I was chained in. Yeah. And I was in a constant battle with myself. Like, you know, I was fighting against that.
Do you know with the withdrawal, did you ever have any strange experiences like brain zaps? It's like an electric shock feeling that goes through your brain, like a twang of a...
Yeah, like a horrible, disgusting, shaky feeling.
Yeah, you could explain it like that, but it's more like an electric shock in your brain. That's what I used to have a lot. And they're very common with withdrawal of antidepressants. Just wondering if you had the same experience or you felt anything like that before.
Yeah, I've had like sort of shooting pains and bad headache sort of things I used to get when I never used to take my tablet and that. But... as soon as you take them tablets, it's like everything stops, and it's like, hey, am I meant to get off these things if I'm making everything sort of better? You know?
Yeah.
People, listen, I can't stress how important it is, like, not to just stop medication, you know? No one should sort of ever do that, you know what I mean? Or I do it, I gradually done it over 3 or 4 sort of months. Because the body gets used to these things, so you have to gradually wean yourself off them. I saying just stop sort of thing. People, if you see anyone out there struggling, your friend or anything, they need words of wisdom, just, you know, go and give them a pat on the back, people, and just tell them I'm all right, everything's going to be okay. Good times are on the way, you know. Go and help your friend. People, I just want to share this quick story with you before I wrap the video up, yeah. But I was with my friend, and to be honest... his mental health I had the best, to be honest, and he sort of leant towards me. He's my producer, his name's James, and he helps me with all this sort of thing. And I saw him struggling there one day, and I thought, you know, what can I do, or sort of thing, to try and enhance him, or just make him happy for today sort of thing, you know. Because it's about breaking people down now, but building them up, you know, we need to remember that. Build your mate up, build your friend up, tell him, say, f*** me, you look great, you're doing brilliant. Well, listen, I'm going off track, but listen back to James. So I seen him, and I thought, how can I do this? Because to be honest, James is hard to get out the house sort of thing. I don't know if it's sort of, I don't know, society, if he's anxious, his mental health, I the best, you know, but I asked him to come up the golf course, and I said, why don't you just give it a chance? And I saw his sort of mind sort of looking. You know, I used to do it. You know, when you're anxious and people text you and you're sitting there on your phone, like, well, you're sitting there on your phone, saying you're lying there on the bed and somebody texts you. And I'm like, oh, why don't we do this tonight? Or why don't we go and have this to eat tonight? Or why don't we go and have a drink here? And you look at the text and you text back saying, oh, I'd love to. Just busy. I'm just busy, you know what I mean? Lying on the bed. But I've done it, you know what I mean? Because I just can't be, I don't know what it is. I don't want to be out there. I don't want to be having conversation. There's just days when I want to just lock off. So yeah, I've sent them texts when I just say, yeah, I'm busy. I'm up to my eyeballs in it. You know what I mean? Or I'm just sitting there on the bed, man, chilling, relaxing. We've all done it. But yeah, so I've seen James's head sort of thinking, and I saw him trying to get out of it sort of thing, you know? I saw his mind working overtime to try and give me an excuse not to sort of come. I said, James, just give it a chance, you know what I mean? You never have to come again. If it's no good, never come again. But if it's all right, you know, you might like it. You might take up, you might get a new hobby. You might be able to, it might help you. So he's come up anyway. We've hit a few golf balls. All we've done is we've hit 100 golf balls, you know what I mean? We've walked up there. We've had a little talk. That's all we've done. There's nothing special in it. We've just had a talk. We've walked up there. And that's it. Fresh air. That's all we had. And did you know what? Yeah, when I seen James up there and I seen him hitting balls and then I seen him smiling, that means everything, you know what I mean? F*** the money, f*** everything. If you can look at someone and they've woke up and their outlook in the morning is terrible, I'm negative, I'm down, and you've just gone in, lifted this person, put a smile on their face. This is what we do it for, do you know what I mean? These are rewards. And the feeling, the warm feeling I had in my chest, it was because of fucking antidepressant that I took or anything like that. All I'd done was made this lad smile, you know, and I just can't stress enough how important it is just to try and make people smile. Because people I'm struggling, they just won't admit it. And it's a shame that it's like that, that they feel sort of fucking stupid to come out with whatever's happening, you know. I mean, it's hard. It took me 5, 6, 7 years to talk about shit. But you know what? I know it's happening out there. And I know how many people know that this has got to. And you know what? We're helping each other. You're helping me and I'm helping you. But listen, nothing beats that feeling I had through taking James out that day. Because, you know what? He'd have sat in his room all day. He'd have had the running thoughts and he'd have had the anxiety and this and that. But you know what, all we did was went for a walk. We hit 50 balls, yeah. As soon as he come back, his outlook was different. He was ready for the day sort of thing. So all I'm saying is, yeah, help your mate, help your friends, help your family. And I see loads of people out there doing good things. Don't ever think I'm saying that these good things don't go on. There's a lot of good friends and a lot of people that I talk to and organisations that I know. They work round the clock with people, talking to them and helping them. I see it up here, whether it's with centres or... There's a lot of people, there's a lot of good people out there and I see the good deeds they do and you know what, I smile when I see it on my phone and I think, mate, it's amazing. If you're one of them people, mate, give yourself a pat on the back.